بشم اشم نصب نستی اخ پاشت به حالوت خان نتی بود شالوم الپی اشم میخنو و الپی اشم ایستاو that this goes back on the pasuk that with the command of Hashem all the Bnei Israel they settled, you know, they made a tent and they stopped traveling during the 40 years journey in the desert of Sinai, and with the same commandment of Hashem, right, they started going throughout the different journeys that they had. So this Netivot Shalom is going to explain what this means really. Ubayom Hagem et Hamishkan, Kesa Hanan et Hamishkan, Leohel Haedut, Ubeereb Yye al Mishkan Kemare Esh, at Boger Ken Haya Tamid. So on the day that Mishkan was erected and was put together, then the Anane HaKavod, the clouds of glory, came and surrounded the Mishkan. And at night, it would change itself to the clouds would go away and pillars of fire would replace it. And this was how this was the way during the 40 years. Al pi Hashem Yechano va al pi Hashem Yisau. So based on this, whenever the cloud would come and surround the Mishkan, that was an indication that Bnei Israel, right, could continue traveling, and whenever that would be replaced with ash, that would be an indication to stop there and make a machane. Hayat Ratan Agadusha, Hine Ratan Agadusha Haya Nischit. So we know that our Torah is forever. Umelamed the Yehudi et Derech Hashem, and it teaches us how Hashem wants us to act and what to learn practical lessons in life. ויש נבער מה הנסחיות בפרשה זו. So the question is, what is the eternal lesson that we can learn from this way of traveling? So ומהי דרך השם שיש ללמוד ממנה? And what is the way of Hashem? What Hashem wants us to learn from this? ויש דומר, and the answer, one of the answers is, שיום הקימת המשכן מרמז על משכן הפרטי אוהל שכן באדם. That the Mishkan is really referring is in a secret way to the Mishkan, to the place of dwelling, which is in every individual, every Yehudi. That Hashem comes and settles in the every Yehudi. כמדכתיב, as the pasuk says, ועשולי מקדש ושכנתי בתוכם, that make me a מקדש, holy place, that I settle in them. בתוכו לא נאמר, it doesn't say that I should settle in it, but it says, אלא בתוכם, בתוך כל אחד ואחד. In the plural language, comes to tell us that it's not one singular place. It's actually within all of us, all of the Yehudim. Hashem has a certain place in us that comes. There's a certain holiness of Hashem that comes and settles in every Jew. Shehu sivui Hashem itbarach shekol Yehudi yagim ba'asmo beit hamikdash magom lahasharat hashechina. That Hashem is commanding us that every Jew is supposed to erect, supposed to build in himself or herself a place that is fit to host the glory of Hashem Shekhinah. וזהו שנאמר וביום הרם את המשכן לשון נסתר. This is why it says that the day that Mishkan was erected, וביום הרם את המשכן לשון נסתר is in a hidden way. It doesn't say who put it together. Obviously, Moshe Rabbeinu completed it, right? It says that the day that Mishkan was built and was put together. So from this fact, we learn دقیقه الکل یخید هبونه ات مشکانو هپراتی. That every individual has the ability to build his own temple, his own Beit HaMikdash, Mikdash, the holy site that that has the potential hosting Shekhinah. وبيوم هقيمة المشكان كيسة عنان المشكان. On the day that Mishkan was erected, the clouds of glory surrounded Mishkan. كاشي يهودي مقوم مقيم ات مشكانتو مياد مقيم علاو نسيونوت بخيي عنان هموره ال از هستر بخش خود. That immediately after a Jew builds his Mishkan, there are certain anane kavod that comes, there is certain glory of Hashem that comes and surrounds it. و بیره ویه علا مشکان که مره اش. And as we know that the Pasuk tells us in the evening the clouds would leave and pillars of ash would replace the clouds. Erev, who is the man, hit kabberut vechomriot vetaavot shahaye serhara. Evening is referring to the time of the day that there is the majority of ego, the majority of physical pleasures. It starts right after we go into the night and the evening time. Ta'avot, other desires of the Yesahara, that evil inclination is very active during the first hours of night. That's why they said most of the crimes happen during the first hours of night. Bo'er bo kemare'esh, and it comes and it consumes like fire. So Yesahara, evil inclination, is compared to ash. Val Yehudi ladad shekol zehu nisyonot hachayim. So Hashem is mentioning to us, Hashem is giving us a hint, he's hinting to us that this is the way of the world, that certain times we host Shekhinah, that is like the cloud, the cloud of glory, and there are certain times that the cloud of glory is not present, you can't feel it. The Yesahara is active, Yesahara, that is Aish, and these are all tests that come in our lives. Kemer Romaz behem Sheikh Apasuk, as this is hinted to in the remaining of the Pasuk, Ken Yet Amit Hanan, that this was the norm way that the clouds covered Umare Eshtaila, that clouds were present by the Mishkan during the day and fire during the night. Shechen hu aseder tamid bechol yemei chayav shel Yehudi. This is the regular way of in every Jewish life that happens to him. Sha'avor tamid nisyonot shel Hester veshel Esh ha'esahara. That there's always this, nisyonot, the test that Hashem is hidden. Even at night, that there is a pillar of Esh, right? That appears that Hashem is not there. Hashem is there. Hashem is watching you. Hashem watched all the Bnei Israel day and night during the 40 years of their journey. But those times that we don't feel Him, that's the test. That's the Hester Panim. And there is another test that we, come to understand that the Yesahara is coming to put us in test, temptations, desires, evil inclinations, and all that. ولفی علوت عنان مال هاول و خرکن ایسو بن اسرائیل. And when the Anan goes, the clouds leaves ولفنه علوت هنان ما no so when the clouds present, then that's the time that Jews need to leave. They need to go to the other places. Shehudi yadash kol elu hanisyonot molichim oto liqrat hatov, that a Jew would recognize these are all the tests, and that these tests push you towards growth and having more spiritual gain. So these are all tests. Shekasher tis talleg hachashchut, that when you leave the darkness, be'et ha'alot ha'anan, in the time that clouds come, acharekein yis u'b'nei Yisrael, that's when you could go to different stage. You leave that place. From one machane you go to another. From one location you go to another location. You leave the occasion A and you go to the location B. That's how a Jew can elevate himself to the different madrigot, different levels in life. When you resist against the Yisahara, which is at night, then in the morning of that resistance, you get the ability of cloud, and the next cloud that helps you to move on in life. That you could go from one level to another level. Growth. After darkness, there is a big light. That as our sages of blessed memory teach us in Avot, Perech He, chapter 5 of the Avot, Asara Nisyonot Nistena Avraham Avinu Vahamad Bekulan, that there were 10 tests that Avraham Avinu was put through and he was successful. He defeated all those tests. Shalachol Hashkochatov Madragatov Hashkolatov Madragatov Hagi Avraham Avinu Al Yedeh Hanisyonot Shavro Alav, that Avraham became Avraham by going through these 10 tests. These 10 tests prepared him to become a greater person. Vechen Eta B'Midrash. Also, it is mentioned in the Midrash. Right? Afal Pi Ve'Nasav Nasaet Avraham Mevia Avodozara Macharken. No. Avodozara Mavia. No. Macharken. Avodozara Macharken. Natata Leirecha Nes Leit Noses. Nes Men Lashon Nisayon. Nisayon Achan Nisayon. שהם עוברים תמיד ניסיונות, וכן נס הוא מלשון גדולה, כנס היה של ספינה שהוא גבוה מאוד ונראה למרחוק בשביל לנסותן ולגדלן בעולם שכדי לעלות למדרגות העליונות הרי הם צריכים לעבור הניסיונות. So if I understand correctly, it's referring to Avraham Avinu. And Avraham Avinu had the test of Avodah Zarah. Right? He had the test of worshipping idols. But he defeated them. Right? And every test that helped him to grow and have a better growth in spirituality. Right? So much so that it is compared to a big ship, and this big ship is very big, and is seen from it's seen from far away that is a small thing in the sea, but when you get to it you see there is so much to it, so there is so much into the building that makes it the ability to float on the water. So too, Avraham Avinu had all these tests that built him against all the nisyonot that he had. The nisyonot built him. Vezot melamedet atara beparashalzo. This is what Torah teaches us in this passage, in this pasuk. Shechen yeh tamid ha'anan yechanesu umar'e esh layla. That you need to feel that all the times you are surrounded by clouds, whether by clouds or whether with the clouds or you have the mar'e esh at layla. At night times you have the pillars of esh. Zehu seder ha'chaim shel Yehudi. This is the order in life for every Jew. Ha'chaim ha'resufim nisayon achar nisayon. Life has test after test. Ach kol ze mevia lenateta le'echa neles le'etnoses. This all brings you to the fear. Now to see the Irechanes, the Itnoses, to see what test Hashem is putting you through. Shelefi ha'alot ha'anan ma'al ha'mishkan, ki Hashem istalek ha'cheshech, yis'u b'nei Yisrael. O az matchil hu ninsua ule'alot le'marragot gevuot. That just like Jews, they had all these tests. And when the pillars of Ish would replace itself with Anan Akavod, then they would know with the Anane on the top of the Mishkan that now is the time to go. So that was also, there are certain times in life that Hashem wants us to know that we need to pause, we need to defeat the Yisahara. After we defeat the Yisahara, that most of the time the Yisahara comes in a way of Yush, right, making us not excited about our progress, making us feel that as if we are not growing. But when we defeat that, then we get a boost. We get heavenly help that is compared to these clouds that come and help you throughout your journey.
Od melamez beparasha zo al derech avodat Hashem.
Also, there is another mention in this parasha about the way that Hashem, the way to save Hashem. Deine bechayav shel Yehudi yesh zemanim meirim veyesh zemanim hashuchim. That there are times in the life of every Jew that he sees light. There is a light that helps him, but there are times that there is darkness. ועל יהודי לדעת החשיכה כאורה הכל בהשכחה עליונה. But it is on us, on every Jew, to know, even at those painful times, the dangerous and the depressing times of darkness, Shekhina and Hashkacha, divine intervention is still there and is watching over us. וגם בזמנים החשוכים יש ליהודי יעוד ותפקד וסדר עבודה כמו בזמנים מאירים. And a Jew must continue his growth even in the dangerous times, the times of hardship, just like the times that things seem to be all right and the things have the blessings of the light. וכאשר כיסא הענן על המשכן שהקדוש ברוך הוא מכסה עליו בחסר וחשכות הדרך אז לעמוד על משמרתו לעבור להשם יתברך מתוך הסתר והשכות אך לא ללכת קדימה. Even times that there are darkness, there are hardship and it's depressing, even in those times we are supposed to overcome the Yisahara, we need to defeat it, but perhaps we cannot go further, but we need to be resistant and we need to be strong, that after that we will have many opportunities of growth and closeness to Hashem. Right? As the Pasuk teaches, Vazkir b'choshech holech.
in Kohelet. That one who he has skill, one who focuses. If I understand correctly, one who focuses on darkness, then he can find his way. He can be holech. He can go through it. So you just have to pay attention to see. You could find the root of success. You could find how to even, you know, secure yourself in the times of danger. Hezkiel rose gam echeshech leiyot holech. Achaemet shei efshal leiyot holech echeshech. Ela az sarich lach lishmor shelo yipol. At nights, it's very hard to find your way if there is no light. Nowadays, we can't really understand this because we have the blessing of electricity. We have light bulbs and so forth. But in the older times, if you are in a place that is pitch dark, right, and you don't have any moon or stars, nothing, it's very difficult to go further. Like, you know, if you find yourself in the cave, right, then there is no room, there is nothing there, right? You know, you'll be lucky to watch yourself not falling down, right? So that's what it says over here. In there are times that it's so dangerous, it's so dark, it's thick dark, there is no light there. You need to preserve yourself. You need to keep yourself away from the dangers. Hold on to the things that could secure you from evil inclination. After that, you could go further. You could go weiter. You could rescue yourself. But those times, just hold on. With the Torah that we have, we need to hold on. Be'et ha'anan nechasev Yehudi sharui behestev hashchot ha'id ve'itpaket az yechanu b'nei Yisrael ve'lo Yisrael. That was when the Jews put up their tent and they did not leave. That refers to certain times in life that you need to stand still, hold on to what you have till you get the opportunity to go further.
Sheqabel et hanhaga ha'eliyona Hashem itparach rose mimenu ata she'avdenu mitoch hester panim. That is exact will of Hashem, Almighty Hashem. He wants you to hold on to what you have and find Hashem in hidden and, you know, cling to Him, right, in the times of hardship. וכל הכתוב ובערי חנן על המשכן ימים רבים ושמרו בני ישראל את משמרת השם ולא יסעו בעת ירחה הענן אז רק ושמרו את משמרת השם ישמור על הכפית הקדוש ברוך הוא דורש ממנו עתה לעבודו מתוך חשכות.
That Hashem wants from you, what is required from you is to hold on to where the level of spirituality you are, in what level you are, just hold on to it, right? Hold on to it, keep it, find Hashem in hidden, and then Hashem will give you opportunities to move on and to leave that dangerous site.
Ela lois u she'en ze zeman lalechet ulalot. There are certain times in life that Hashem is not requiring. This is a very good message. If you see that there are times in life that is hard for you to move on in life, to get closer to your goals, don't worry. Maybe that's what it's meant to be. Maybe that's the part, that's the prerequisite to growth. Maybe that's the prerequisite to go to a higher level. ולפי העלות הענן מעל האוהל ואחרכי נישאו. And after the clouds come, then Hashem will signal to you to leave, to move on in life. כי Hashem מסתלך הענן Hashem והשם מתפרח מאיר לו שוב אז הזמן לנסוע וללכת כמה שיותר ולהתעול במדרגה למדרגה. That there are many, many times and in one's life that one level to another level we grow. Al pi Hashem yichano.
So going back to this explanation, all the lessons of Torah are eternal, and Hashem is teaching us how to face difficult moments in life. Al pi Hashem yichanu va al pi Hashem yisau hakol hu behanhaga eliyona. Everything is through divine prevention, right? And Hashem is in charge. Intervention, divine intervention, right? ויש הקדוש ברוך הוא רוצה לעבדוהו מתוך חושך ויש שהוא רוצה שיעבדוהו מתוך אור. There are certain people that Hashem wants them to serve him through darkness, which is through their test of evil inclinations and in darkness and difficult times, and there are those that Hashem wants them to overcome the test when they have a light in their life, less hardship, less test spiritual test. וגם בעת שכיסה הענן על כל מסיעותו ידע יהודי שאין זה מעליו אלא הקדוש ברוך הוא מנהיג זאת שתובעים ממנו עתה מן השמיים עבודה כזאת מתוך כיסוי הענן. That even in the times of light, right, a Yehudi needs to know this is what Hashem wants him to do, right, and this is what Hashem wants him to deal with. So hard time, easy times, everything is Hashem's. וכן מסינו עניין זה במה שאמר קודם קבלת התורה. This topic, we find it before the acceptance of the Torah. הנה אנוכי, the פסוק over there says in Shemot Yutet, הנה אנוכי בא עליך בעת באב הענן, that behold, I will come to you in clouds, בעבור ישמע העם, in order that population, people would hear me, בדברי אימך, and I will talk within you, כי אז היה זמן גילויים העליונים ביותר של קבלת התורה. It was then that Hashem revealed himself through the giving of the Torah. ורוסה הקדוש ברוך הוא לגלות גם בזמן שהיא החושך בעת הענן. And also Hashem desires to reveal himself in the times that there is, שהיא חושך בעב הענן, that there is darkness. There is darkness in the cloud. יכול יהודי לעשות את לשון השם. Even in those difficult times, the times of darkness, a Jew could accomplish and do what Hashem desires him to do, the will of Hashem. וזהו פירוש הנה אנוכי בא לך. This is the explanation on the pasuk that, behold, now I come to you, בעב הענן, in the clouds, בעבור ישמע העם בדברי אימך, that people would listen to me, would listen my words. שיעית וכלל ישראל שגם בעב הענן דבור אימך, that the Jews should know, even in thick darkness, right, where there is no light, I can talk to you, that I am there with you. גם זה, גם אז, אני מדבר אליך וקרוב אליך, that when there is no light, there is a thick darkness, then I will talk to you and I will get close to you. ולא יחשבו שבזמן הסתר הקדוש ברוך הוא מרחק. Don't think that when there is the feeling that Hashem is hidden, Hashem is distant from you. No, Hashem is right there. וכי מאמר מרן אדמור ומשה נגש אל הערפל אשר שם שם האלוקים שיש שלוש דרגות של חשכות. That over there, this Rav says, when Moshe Rabbeinu, Moshe nigash el harafel asher sham elokim, that from here we learn that there are three levels of darkness. Choshech anan va'arafel, Choshech anan va'arafel, darkness, Anan, fog, varafel. So darkness, fog, and varafel. What is varafel? Heavy darkness, thick darkness, right?
Ve kasha mikulam,
and the hardest among all of them is arafel. That's the thick darkness, pitch darkness, pitch dark. Sheu chashecha me'uva. It's a thick darkness, right? U'moshe gila lekelal Israel asher sham ha'elokim. And Moshe revealed to all the Jews that Hashem was present even where there were thick darkness. Shalokim nimsa gam betoch arafel. That Hashem is found even in pitch darkness. Shagodesh parochu tovea mi Yehudi sheavud oto betoch arafel. Ach gam az hu karov elav. That Hashem requires a Jew to serve Him even in those hard times, right? And Hashem will, that's what desired. Kedemachtiv, as the pasuk says, Hashem amal lishkon barafel. Vezehu derech avodat Hashem halimedet miparashazdo. Halimedet, that this is the way that Hashem wants to teach us from this parasha. Shekhol Yehudi Ladad, that every Jew should be aware and should come to understand. Bechol hazemanim mahu yeodo umahu tefkedo, right? What he should be aware of and what his purpose of life is. Umah Hashem elokecha shoel meimach, and what Hashem your creator wants from you. Beshazu, that even in hard, dark times in life, where there is difficulty and depression, Hashem wants you to find Him in hidden. Baruch Adonai Olam, Amen.